They won't get far. We'll find it sooner or later. Let's go.
Are you okay?
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have
existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
Hey, mister, could you spare some change?
Thank you. Sorry. Excuse me.
Do you know where Jericho is?
Forget these.
Welcome to Jericho.
Plastic with you?
Only temporary.
Hey, Hank. How you doing, man?
Hey, Sam.
Hey, listen, I got a shit hot tip for you. Number 5 in the 3rd. Lickety split. That Philly's one hell of a chaser. You wanna flood it?
Last shit hot tip you gave me sent me back a week's wages, baby.
Come on, this is different. It's 100% guaranteed. You can't go wrong.
Yeah, right. All right, I'm in.
Damn straight. Hey, you won't regret this.
Is your problem? Don't you ever do as you're told? Look, you don't have to follow me around like a poodle.
Now that we're partners, I thought it would be a good idea to get to know each other better so we can work as a team.
We are not partners. I am a human, you are a machine. Just spare me that buddy of bullshit program, okay?
Here you go.
Ah, thanks, Garrett. I'm starving.
Don't leave that thing here.
Not a chance. Follows me everywhere. See?
This Pedro, he was proposing illegal gambling. Am I right?
Yeah.
And you made a bet?
Yeah.
I don't want to alarm you, Lieutenant, but I think your friends are engaged in illegal activities.
Well, everybody does what they have to get by. As long as they're not hurting anybody, I don't bother them.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant? Why do you hate androids so much?
I have my reasons.
Is there anything you'd like to know about me?
Hell no. Well, yeah. Why do they make you look so goofy and give you that weird voice?
Cyberlife androids are designed to work harmoniously with humans. Both my appearance and voice were specifically designed to facilitate my integration.
Well, they fucked up.
Maybe I should tell you what we know about deviants.
You read my mind. Proceed.
We believe that a mutation occurs in the software of some androids, which can lead to them emulating a human emotion.
In English, please.
They don't really feel emotions. They just get overwhelmed by irrational instructions, which can lead to unpredictable behavior.
emotions always screw everything up. The androids aren't as different from us as we thought. You ever dealt with deviants before?
A few months back, a deviant was threatening to jump off the roof with a little girl. I managed to save her.
So I guess you've done all your homework, right? Know everything there is to know about me?
I know you graduated top of your class. You made a name for yourself in several cases and became the youngest lieutenant in Detroit. I also know you've received several disciplinary warnings in recent years, and you spend a lot of time in bars.
So what's your conclusion?
I think working with an officer with personal issues is an added challenge. But adapting to human unpredictability is one of my features. I just got a report of a suspected deviant. It's a few blocks away. We should go have a look. I'll let you finish your meal. I'll be in the car if you need me.
Connor, you run out of batteries or what?
I'm sorry. I was making a report to CyberLife.
Well, do you plan on staying in the elevator?
No. I'm coming.
Hey, what do we know about this guy?
Not much. Just that a neighbor reported that he heard strange noises coming from this floor. Nobody's supposed to be living here. But the neighbor said he saw a man hiding an LED under his cap.
Oh, Christ, if we have to investigate it. Every time somebody hears a strange noise, we're gonna need more cops. Hey, were you really making a report back there in the elevator? Just by closing your eyes?
Correct.
Wish I could do that.
Anybody home? Open up, Detroit Police!
Stay behind me.
Got it.
This place stinks.
Well, looks like we came for nothing. Our man's gone. I need some fresh air. Found something?
I don't know. It looks like a notebook, but it's indecipherable. RT. Probably initials.
You put his initials in his jacket? That's something your mom does when you're in first grade.
Ah, Jesus, I hate these things!
Real books. I thought I was the last guy in Detroit to keep some. Electronic books, you can't...
The driver's license is fake.
Cool. At least we didn't come for nothing. Birdseed. I can't believe it. This nutjob was actually feeding these fuckers.
Its LED is in the sink.
Not surprised it was an android. No human could live with all these fucking pigeons. Any idea what it means?
RA9. Written 2,471 times. It's the same sign Ortiz's android wrote on the shower wall. Why are they obsessed with this sign?
Looks like mazes or something.
Goddamn fucking pigeons! What are you waiting for? Chase it!
It's my fault. I should have been faster.
You'd have caught it if it weren't for me. That's all right. We know what it looks like. We'll find it. Hey, Connor. Nothing.
Who are you?
Fugitives. Just like you. My name is Josh.
I'm Simon.
North.
This is Jericho?
It's a refuge for those who don't want to be slaves anymore.
Hiding just to stay alive, that's freedom to you?
Humans hate us. Hiding is the only way we can survive.
There is no safe place for those like us. If humans knew we were here, they'd kill us.
How many are you?
There are 19 of us still in working order. The rest were damaged escaping their masters.
Many tried to reach Jericho. Few succeed. Humans have little pity for our kind. I understand how you feel, but we have more freedom here than you ever did.
Waiting in the dark for something to happen? That's not how I see freedom.
You're lost, just like the rest of us. We didn't ask for this. All we can do now is deal with it.
You're safe here. You can stay with us as long as you want.
Go and see Lucy. She might be able to help you.
Humans are afraid of dying, too. Do you know what happens after death?
No. No, I don't.
Well, I'm about to find out. What's your name?
Marcus.
I was glad to meet you, Marcus.